quantization.
So it can be according to Hahnemann and according to the to more possibilities.
In my opinion, there is only one possibility for the whole the Hahnemannian quantization. There is no other quantization which is effective. And if you are going anti-clockwise, you are actually destroying the molecule.
You're right. These things have to be considered.
And if you are going clockwise, you are increasing the strength of the molecules.
Yeah, you're right.
So, in homeopathy, we potentize and we dynamize things for at clockwise. If we are triturating it, we do it clockwise. And we, Mark was saying that what is the fun to use it for, to do this 1 hour in three sessions, 20 minutes per session. The secret is that when you triturate, a lot of thing, you know, can go and it can go with pestle and mortar, and it will then stick with it. So we have to scratch it. And then we will start number one, this is number one. The second one is the potentized energy should be stored in the molecule. And then you can again potentize it for another 20 minutes. And the same process is repeated for another 20 minutes. 1 hour potentization gives you 1x.
I respect very much. I am not really into the potentization process. I am more, you have to see me as an agronomist, an extensive man who goes and talks with the farmers and tries to convince them to enter into this no man's world where they can spray with water. And their first reaction is,
and why you call it homeodynamics?
Are you crazy? I wish I'm going to spray with water. But now they do. Now even they feel very much at ease with it. Okay, give us something new now. What have we understood that?
Why you call it homeodynamic?
Because of the potentization.
Because of the potentization.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you think that potentization is definitely replaces the homeo? Where is homeo?
You are right. There is some. We have to be careful. You're right. How much time do you have?
Time. Well, as long as you need. We've got all day, and I don't know if our Indian man's going to turn up. So, officially, you've got 15 minutes.
Okay.
But take your time. Okay. If you've got good things to say, we're ready.
So, I have to say, I have more things to show, and then you can come back with questions.
Just okay. Okay, please.
Just not to lose the schedule and the
moment.
Yeah. So, olive oil section, please.
You're coming.
We don't want to lose the essential oil. Essential oil.
Essential oil?
No, we don't want to lose the essential oil.
More oil? Yeah. Potatoes. I think it's interesting for Britain to UK. The products are more or less the same, like harmonizer, pest repellent, and a special kind of 501, which goes to the root. So it is the root plus product in English. Yeah. Okay, what we have, very important for the farmer, 30% more yield. This is quite clear. It was a field divided in two. Same field, same earth, same soil, same potato variety. So more yield. And this is not the only thing. Then we took for analysis the tubers, potato tubers, and the homeodynamic ones had more sugar content by 33%. This you can tell by from the taste. So each one of us is a laboratory. We can't say if we like something because the consumer finally decides and votes for the products. He has to like it. If the method is to be accepted. But it's good also to have a number from the laboratory, like this one. And a another aspect, apart from the quantities, apart from measurable things, is the form, the shape. You can see some of it here, and this is very clear now, that some of the potato tubers are deformed. Is that right in English?
Mm-hmm.
Deformation, yeah. You can see some shapes, with a glyph here, which...
Spindle-like shape. You have spindle-like, spindles. Spindles.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Spindle.
Okay. Of course, we talk a little bit with statistics. It's not that all homodynamic were perfect, but it's the percentage. Inorganic, just organic, we have 14%, while homodynamic only 5% deformations. This is also going back to the quantity, because a housewife can really use mainly the well-formed potatoes. And the other ones are kind of a loss, or she has to give them to animals or something. I want to ask you something. Do you see the difference? Maybe the slide is not so good. Do you see different other difference between the two?
The color.
Color.
Yeah.
Color.
Yes, color.
The shine.
And the size.
The shine and the color. Yeah.
The size.
Same variety.
The size of the.
The size. The size. Yeah. The size explains the quantity. Yeah.
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 And we'd see that there was a pair of seed from the same batch as well. Or
yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and this man was very happy, and he's continued to grow his potatoes like this. Also, what we did was a seed bath on potatoes before planting. This is another aspect of thermodynamics. I will go back to it later. any question for Teletim?
His left side, was it achieved after some years of biologic dynamic farming, or just after the first year? Or?
So it was some years organic.
Okay.
And then it was the first year of homodynamic.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, results can occur soon, quite soon. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If not other question, I will. Oh, maybe just talk about wine ground a bit. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Vine growing, making wine or grapes is quite important for us in Greece, also South Africa. I know. I don't have slides, I can present you some experience. First one was the sugar content. You heard that on the potatoes, and for the vines, it's very important. In many cases where there's not enough sun, like in the north part, where there are many rains during the maturation, the grapes cannot really achieve maturity. And it's a pity, you see a lot of grapes standing there, they're not good to harvest, and this part of the harvest is lost. This maybe you have it in Germany too, or in England, if you have grapes. Huh? We have it in north of Greece, or in high up in the mountains. And it's very important what we achieve. It's measured, it's not really a big test, but it's quite simple to see that you have plus 1 up to 1.5 more Baume scale degrees. That is a good thing, you can start to harvest. And this comes earlier in the season. So you avoid problems with botrytis disease, it's a fungal disease. One thing is that. Other thing is powdery mildew resistance. These are experiences made in the island of Samos, which is an island very close to Turkey, if you have been there. I go back a little bit to the good practice. Practice pruning, etc. has to be very good. So in a case where the farm workers made a terrible mistake they took all the leaves almost out, and this caused a terrible stress to the plant, and we had an epidemic of the powdery mildew. But having divided in two, the homeodynamic part at the end gave 70% more production. It's not good to refer, but just an experience. We can understand both the importance of good practice and second, the better resistance in homeodynamics. This was the year 2005, and this year, 2011, we had the normal mildew, the Peranospora, Plasmopara reticula, and while in all of Greece, because of the rains in May, in June, it was a disaster. Farmers, olive vine growers were protesting, asking for help. The government, of course, doesn't have money to give. And so, you know, there were articles written, the damage normally was around 50% because of the mildew. In our homeodynamic part, the damage was limited to 20%. I think and I know it, the farmers are satisfied. We've written articles on that on newspapers in Greece. And the farmers that were skeptical at the first, now they ask me, what did we do? We want to do it.
What's the general reaction to this from the media and from the farming community? Is it
Are
they skeptical? Or?
There were negative reactions from the farmers, sometimes teasing, you know, laughing at us because we spray water and we deal with the stars. It's not very accepted. But then when we see the results, they really knock at the door, at our door, and ask for it.
Well, you know, now's the time to do it because there's a major crisis.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Now's the time to get in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that without any copper spray? No.
There was some copper spray. We could not avoid that. Yeah. I hope in the future we can. But not yet. I have to be honest. I would like it.
You can have your dam and dynamite copper.
It can be too.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then you will see better results than from the pure copper spray itself.
Okay.
That's my experience.
Good.
Okay.
I would like to hear that.
Yeah, possible.
Okay. So olives, potatoes, wine producing. Let's go back to the slides. Yeah. Other very clear result we have is with the germination rate of seeds. This, in order to be understood, a little bit of Steiner is needed and understand the importance of the seed, because it is there that everything lies hidden as a possibility. And in this very sensitive stadium, if you give some impulse, then this impulse can, like the projector here, from a little point can be projected to the plant later. Like the rays of light will go like that.
Yes.
And you can see that at the very beginning with the germination rate. Like here, this Calendula officinalis, it's marigold.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can see here the germination of organic seed, very good quality, 65%. And here, 90 to 95%. You can see that. Tell it for yourself whether it is true or not. And still, I want to bring a point that may interest you. We made other experiments too, and then we cannot always see difference when the germination rate is good. So when in organic it is 90%, in homeodynamic it's almost the same. You cannot really see a statistical difference. I bring this to you because I want your opinion later to discuss on why sometimes we cannot really see an effect of homeopathy. My understanding is that when the vital force is low, you can clearly see the effect of having it. In other cases, if a man is already, you know, strong and shining, and OK, Okay, what can you do better with it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
You can get the same results as you have here with Calendula. You can use, when you use Simca. Simca seed bath.
Okay.
And you also get like 95-98% germination rate.
Good. Thank you.
Whereas without it, it is 60-65%.
Yeah. So to make clear, Calendula is not the preparation, Calendula is the plant.
Okay. Yeah.
So we had seed of Calendula. According to the people that make in nurseries, it's Calendula is not always easy to germinate. They have problems sometimes. Okay. Another one of my first experiments with radish seeds. Sorry that is in Greek. With the bath seed, and I want to bring another interesting aspect for me. I had an organic and homeodynamic plot. And in the beginning I thought homeodynamics is nothing, because if you take this part of the fixture, which is better?
And the right one looks better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But later, you see, it's not only the quantity, it is that the homeodynamic preparation is addressing to the essence of the plant. Mm-hmm. And the essence of the radish is the root. So it's not only quantity, it's the quality of the essence. The same thing more or less at Marietun and the days of sowing according to the moon. Okay. And of course, the taste, you imagine, what is the better? This was sweeter and juicier and softer, while the other one was going woody, you know, you cannot really, and very strong burning taste, you don't really want to eat that.
Excuse me, I want to ask you an essential question.
Yeah.
Do you use only water for homeopathy?
Mainly water.
Exactly. There's no medicine in it.
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. If I bring some anthroposophic or philosophical language, this has to do with linking the plant to its archetype. More or less Plato's idea that the real world isn't but an expression of the idea that lies somewhere in the skies, in the heavens, and this idea can be expressed on the material level, and maybe we can help this expression with means like that. And another way to help this expression, if we talk about trees, and we have them there, and we cannot really make a seed bath, is with Mark, how do you put a small bottle under the tree?
Exactly, there's no simple word for it, you know, to describe it.
Small bottle under the tree. So it actually is what its name says, that you take a small bottle of the homeopathic product and you
bury it.
Bury it, yeah.
Under the tree. Bottle open or closed?
It's closed. It's closed, yeah. And I had this experience myself with many farmers, but myself, I have an almond orchard, almond, almendras.
Excuse me.
Yes.
How did you know that you have prepared the homeodynamic preparation up to the mark? How did you know?
Up to
the mark. That we prepare the trenches, 30 trenches. We know after 29 it is going to be 30 and we need 30.
Yes. Yeah.
But what is the unit of homodynamics?
What is the unit?
In our homeopathy, there are decimal units and there are centesimal units.
Yeah.
What are the units and what unit is needed in plants? Mm-hmm. Sometimes we use 200 C centesimal scale.
I can tell you what I know. I know that the potencies are low. Are decimals and low. I cannot really tell you exactly because I'm not making the preparations. I told you before I'm applying them.
You are applying them, you are not preparing it.
No.
And how they come to know that this is 10?
Practice, experience of others.
And that is not the same thing approach.
And maybe insight.
From 9 to 10.
And practice,
eight,
practice,
eight, eight, eight to nine, eight to nine, no, practice, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, that is centigrade. But if you say it is coming from generation to generation, that is not centigrade.
No, I'm not saying practice is, means experiments and see what works and what not.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. And regarding the small bottle, but as we described it here, sorry, right.
Is that 100 mils or?
Just 60 ml.
60.
Oh, no, smaller, 10 ml. Yes. Very small. I can say my experience from the old ones I grew. Year 2009 was very bad. My orchard is, I'm really bad with my trees. I make an experiment, how much can they survive without fertilization. So year 2009, many trees died out of the drought. Actually, all the trees died, I mean, except of those who had the small bottle. And this was a very clear message for me. You can see it's dead, and this is thriving. To be honest, I bring another aspect, that surviving trees were those with the bottle, or with, you know about the natural, of course you know, natural state of pruning, like the central eggs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So these trees all survived, and I guess they have a better connection with the cosmos, with the archetype, yeah. without blue bottle, but they have better health because of the shape. And the trees that were out of seed. So how do you call those trees?
So they weren't grafted?
Yeah, no grafted.
They're grown from seed.
From seed, and they are going well without bottle, and yeah. Because again, the seed was there and was better adapted and better communicating to the cosmos. Yeah.
What do you put in the bottle? What do you put in the bottle?
The homeodynamic preparations.
But you put the bottle next to the trunk?
Yeah, under the trunk. This is another thing we do as an endodynamic group in Greece. We try to find out whether these practices were known in the past or not. And actually, we find many of them were known in peasant tradition, even the bottle, even other things. Mm-hmm. It's what Steiner says, go back and find what the peasants were doing. I don't have the time to do it, but go and do it.
Yeah.
And I feel that's a task, to go and see in the times of Theophrastos, which was the disciple of Aristoteles, or in the Byzantine times, where we have written things, or in the Middle Age, later, what people were doing. Because there is a lot of knowledge ignored nowadays. And some of it we can use.
Yes, we have a question.
Yes.
Is it a glass bottle?
A glass bottle. According to what we know, glass is a semi-porous material.
It's a liquid, it's not a solid.
Yes. A very fine, a microporosity. Eh? Yeah. What is it?
Yeah. What is the best hour of the day for apply the spray?
The spray?
Yes.
Usually very early in the morning.
Very early in the morning.
As with 501. Like 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock in the morning. And then, you know, as for biodynamics, when there is a product for the earth pool, like for the humus, it's better to spray it during nighttime. And close night, like 7 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the evening. And then even close to the full moon. Like the same principles with biodynamics. Talking about biodynamics, I bring another piece of work we're doing, and this is the humus project. So we get a very dry field in an area with desertification problems. You know, the land is getting dry and dry. And then we do classical 500 with a combination of grape juice. This Enzo took the idea from Steiner's medicine courses, because the grape juice helps the internal processes, and humus is a process.
Yeah.
And we had a very good result, like going from 1.8 to 3% humus in 2 years' time. I think this is very encouraging for all areas affected by drought, like Mediterranean, North Africa, Australia, whatever. It gives me to find out in which instances we have to use classical biodynamics and in which homeodynamics. In a way, biodynamics deal with the soil, so the earth is seen as the mother of the plant. And if the mother is healthy, no, this very much affects the health of the plant. And as Alex Podolinsky says, you don't have to do anything more. Yeah. But this is a view. And the other view is to help the plant as an organism, because the plant is a wonderful thing. There are so many processes, life processes going on. Like, you know, root and vegetation, and then flowering, and then seed formation, and you can help these processes. And Steiner very clearly says, we have to understand the life processes. What creates life? How the... Okay, let me close it. Yeah. And what I see is that when the humus content is high, you can do homeodynamics, because there is already a good level of vital forces. When not, one has to go back to classical biodynamics and maybe come back to homeodynamics later and combine. This is one of the main things I understand and share with you.
What about the water you use?
The water?
Yeah.
Is it the ground water, or it is distilled water, or it is purified water, like...
For potatization, you mean, or irrigation?
For all purposes, for Roman animals, what water is used?
So, for potatization, I'm not 100% sure, but not distilled water, not tap water, but very good quality water. Very good quality. For irrigation, we have to deal with whatever it is there, and there are devices to improve the quality, like special spirals or things you put inspired by flow force, but not flow force anymore, they are different. Yeah.
I'm asking only because it is a new thing for me. And the water you are using, is it the ground water, or is it the distilled water, or is it the mineral water?
I cannot really respond to that. Enzo should be here to respond to that. Because he's making the comparisons. Sorry.
I know a little bit of an answer to that.
Yeah.
Well, you talked about polarity of Father Sky and Mother Earth.
Yeah.
And from Enzo, he was saying that he collects the rainwater, which comes down.
Yeah, right.
For these preparations, and the spring water that comes up for the Mother Earth spring.
Thank you. Just to check if there is something.
We're running a bit short of time now.
Yeah, I think that's it for the moment. Thank you for your...
We have 5 minutes to stretch our legs, and then we'll come back for Nuria's talk.
5 minutes only?
5 minutes.
Yeah. Oh,
3 minutes.
Shall we ask someone?
It depends on how long you want to stretch your legs.